myself not here to stand in moral judgment.
I don't think the lawyers were talking about Times Now and Star.
No, I am asking you here today.
Would you say that the Indian media has been...
Ms. Paratkar, let me ask you this question. Do you believe the Indian media's responsibility is to build a case for the Talwars?
Not at all. I think it's the responsibility of the media to follow the truth.
So if the truth,
if the truth
is to bring to light the details of the CBI closure report or the alleged involvement of the parents, is it sacrilegious for the media to do so?
Not at all. But you have to.
So where is the motive coming
in? My point is, we don't send a reporter to either side and just take down what they're saying.
I think, to that, Ms. Paratkar, you are saying that you don't take a reporter to take down whatever you're saying. You don't want us to take the CBI at face value on the basis of its closure report. May I ask you respectfully in turn, why you expect us to take the CBI theory of 2008, holding the servants responsible at face value, if you don't want us to take the CBI closure report on the involvement of the parents at face value?
Sure, because the CBI, it's inconsistent with its own
how
reports.
Is it consistent? How is it consistent when it declares the Talwars innocent? And how is it inconsistent when it declares the when it says the Talwars their involvement could be possible? How is it?
I am saying take everything critically.
But precisely, that's precisely the point.
I don't have a very good audio here, but I don't believe that we, as the media, we've been very critical.
Well, I think, Ms. Paratkar, you don't understand this, that the media is not there as a sounding board to give the point of view of the Talwars.
It's not.
And I don't understand this because, you know, frankly, you know, it is a fact. And I don't know why Avirukh is appearing so hurt in this particular case. The fact is, there is an extreme interest in this case.
I'm not hurt at all.
Either we are open to ourselves as society or not.
Why should I be hurt? Avirukh,
realize this, please.
You've gotten angry about this.
Avirukh, please understand this.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, let's talk about it. But you must listen. You must listen also to that.
Let's talk about it openly.
Yeah, let's talk about it openly.
I am listening.
So the fact is this, if you just care to listen.
I believe, as a journalist of some standing, I believe that our job is what? It is one, not to write fiction, and two, to question stuff, not to be stenographers.
How many people were standing there on the rooftops giving how many front pages, how many programs, how much outrage? How many people stood out there when the servants were declared guilty? You tell me.
No.
You tell me today. Shobhade, how many people were standing there when the servants were declared guilty?
Absolutely.
How many were? How many were there? Shobhade.
No one.
That depended on the number of Obi vans sent
not
by your
one.
Channel.
Oh, come on.
Not
no, come on.
No one was interested.
I've been,
please
no,
understand.
No, media
look,
that
I've attended hearings in this case.
Please.
I've attended hearings in this case where there's one journalist and that's me.
1 second, Avirukh. Please. You know, I'm talking of 2008.
I'm talking about 2008 and the uncomfortable question is this.
Is there a media bias in favor of, do some people have a bias in favor of the Talwars only because of the belief that while blue-collared servants can commit heinous crimes, but white-collared men cannot?
Not just that.
Now, you don't want me to ask that uncomfortable question.
That's absurd.
Well, you don't want to ask those uncomfortable questions. In the United States...
Please ask it. I just say it's absurd.
Well, I mean, these are very fundamental questions.
No, I know they may be fundamental to you. They're absurd to me.
Well, they may be absurd to you, but these are questions we need to be asked whether you're comfortable with them or not, Mr. Avirukh, sir.
I would like to point out to you.
Mr. Talwar, can I ask you something? How many times in 2008, Mr. Talwar, listen to me, Mr. Talwar, answer my question tonight. My question is to you, and I hope you will give me a straight and honest reply. I want to ask you, Mr. Talwar, when were the servants held guilty? Tell me the date. Tell me the date.
I think Krishna was arrested on, I think they were arrested on different dates. Krishna was arrested on 13th of June and the others were arrested.
One minute. Let me go. My question.
10 minutes, Krishna was taken by Ghaziabad police.
R.K. Anand, yes, what are you saying, Mr. Anand?
I am saying within 10 minutes of the murder, the moment was FIR was registered, Krishna was picked up by the Ghaziabad police, kept in custody, an application was filed before the court that they were kept with them on the condition that their life is in danger. They kept with them for 2 months till the CBI came into picture. And then they were arrested much later on. An application was filed in the court of law, make an allegation that they were put in custody and used and tortured them by the Ghaziabad police and same by the CBI.
Right. So my question is, I just wanted to follow up on the line of questioning with Mr. Dinesh Talwar. Mr. Talwar, you are aware that the CBI at that point of time said that Rajkumar in his narco analysis confessed that he and Krishna went back to Arushi's room. They hit her with a sharp object and then they slit her throat. You are aware of that? That they said that in 2008. Did they or did they not say that?
I don't think this is on record, but I think the record of the CBI in the court says that both Rajkumar and Krishna were involved in this crime.
So,
and their scientific tests are positive.
Right. So reconstructing the scene of the crime, Arun Kumar said that Rajkumar, Krishna and Talwar's domestic help consumed alcohol, went to the room, gagged, tried to assault her, scuffle broke out. In that thing, the whole incident happened. They also said that there was a friendly entry to the house and hence Hemraj was involved. How many weeks and how many days, in your view, did the CBI take to come to this conclusion? A few weeks? A few days, perhaps?
This press conference that you're talking about is 11th July 2008.
11th July 2000, so maybe 7 weeks? 6 weeks? How many days since the CBI took the case over?
1st June.
You welcome that. Did you at that point of time ask how they had rushed to the conclusion? Did you at that point of time ask whether
exactly
they had built
the
enough
point
evidence?
I'm making. Whether
did
it
you
was
ask?
The servants or it was
did you,
the
did you ask?
Talwars,
did
it
you,
was your responsibility as the media.
Did you,
excuse me, are you telling me it's my responsibility
ask?
To ask these questions?
Did you ask
or was
any
it the
questions?
Responsibility of the media
no,
to
no,
ask these
did,
questions?
Did you ask
no,
any
I'm
questions?
No, I'm asking you, did the media ask the questions
the
or not?
Of course the media asked the questions.
You are making, I'm sorry, please don't try to stop me from speaking.
Mr. Talwar.
The one promise you made was that you will let me speak. Let me
Mr.
complete
Talwar,
my sentence.
Are you answering my question? My question is simply this,
the,
that do you believe?
Yes,
do
I'm
you
going
believe,
to answer your
do
question
you believe,
perfectly.
Do you
please
the
listen
question
to me.
Is this,
my
Mr.
Previous,
Talwar?
Let me answer
Mr.
now.
Mr. Talwar, the question. Allow me the question. I'll give you a full time to reply right after that. Just one question I will ask you. Please let me ask the question, Mr. Talwar. My question to you is, do you believe that there was a possibility that the CBI in the first case in 2008 was rushing to the facts? And did you do anything about it?
Arnab, I thought the issue over here was about a media trial. You have changed the topic completely. Number two,
everything is in the context
neither
of the
topic. Responsibility for the first team nor the responsibility of the second topic.
Are you avoiding
of the second
my question?
Team was mine. It is the responsibility. One second. It was the responsibility. What
you
were talking over
question?
Here was, what is the responsibility of the media? The question was, in both cases, it was the responsibility of the media to check the facts. Now, let me tell you, it is on record that during one of the conversations, the Times of India reported that Dr. Dinesh Talwar wondered that is it possible that a person could get angry enough to kill based on the scolding which was given. And this is with regards to Krishna. So the question is, it is not me who was doing the investigation, and it was not me who was reporting the investigation.
You avoided my fairly straightforward question in that.
I am not avoiding your question. I am saying what you are saying is it was my responsibility to ask whether the media, whether the CBI was doing a correct
but
job.
But you don't understand, Mr. Talwar.
Of the media.
Mr. Talwar, today you've got it. You've got
whether
it wrong.
Whether it was the servants, and please don't make this into a rich versus the poor issue.
Well, 1 minute.
It is a question of justice. Whether it is a poor person or it is a rich person, your responsibility is to ensure justice. Your responsibility is to ensure that you make sure that all the facts come out. If the facts did not come out about the servants, you are equally culpable. If the facts did not come out about the Talwar, you are equally culpable. The same stays in both the conditions.
Mr. Talwar,
I'm sorry, I have not changed my facts at
all.
I have not changed what I've seen from the beginning. In the beginning itself, I told you, Arnab, it is, I respect the media. I respect the media for covering every aspect, but the objective is to bring out the truth.
Mr. Talwar, understand this. The simple point I'm making to you, I made this right at the start. Why don't you understand this? The fact of the matter remains that the CBI's closure report raised a number of questions about the role of the parents. We have utmost respect for whatever the court decides. Court decides this way or that. That's the final judgment of the courts. We respect the courts. The media is not manufacturing questions or manufacturing facts. It's basing them on the basis of the CBI's report.